Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters, with the arrival of the Layali al-Qadr, the nights of power, as some like to call it or call them, I would like to give you a brief description of the importance of these nights and then go into explaining some of the general acts, the general a'mal, which one is required to do in these holy nights. First of all, it is very important, brothers and sisters, that we engage in the supplication and repentance towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the common a'mal and acts of these nights, which you can practice during the three nights, the 19th, the 21st, and the 23rd, is the first is al-ghusl, is the major ablution, that is called. You do a ghusl just after the adhan of Maghrib of that night. You go have a shower, and your intention is that I am doing ghusl, purification, for Laylatul Qadr, to prepare myself to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to supplicate, to speak to my Creator. There are those who have been away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the past year. Now it is their chance. You stand before Allah and say, "Oh Allah, forgive me." So prepare yourself, do ghusl, and have the intention that you will stay awake during that night, during Laylatul Qadr. It is advisable that you do ihya, that you stay awake until the morning. You engage in supplication. There are many supplications we have received from Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, as it is narrated in the books of dua, for example, the kitab, the book Mafatihul Jinan, which is written and compiled by Sheikh Abbas al-Qum, and other books. And of course, you can go online and search the a'mal. There are many narrations that explain to you the a'mal and the supplications that need to be practiced. So the first being the ghusl, the purification of oneself, and the intention to stay awake, ihya, either in supplicating the Holy Quran, supplicating, reciting dua, reciting ziyarah, or even studying the knowledge of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. We have in narrations some part of ihya, a part of keeping awake and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Layal al-Qadr could be spent in educating oneself in the knowledge of Ahlul Bayt, in the aqa'id, in the beliefs, in the tafsir of the Holy Quran narrated and derived by Ahlul Bayt's information and knowledge. And one can learn the ahkam of his religion, for example, ahkam of salah, ahkam of fasting. You can educate your family, you can educate your children, you can spend hours of Laylatul Qadr by doing that. This is one of the best things you can do in Laylatul Qadr. For example, it is recommended that you recite 100 or so rak'ah of salah, of prayers. The third act is seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repenting towards Him by repeating the phrase Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayk 100 times or more. The more the merrier. Take a prayer bead, a sibha. Sit down on your prayer mat, or if you are sitting, for example, at home or engaging in other activities and you are at the same time able to supplicate towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, repeat Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayk, Astaghfirullah Rabbi wa atubu ilayk. These supplications, these will elevate our spirits and elevate us to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fourth general act that one should practice during these three nights is the raf'al masahif. You open the Holy Quran, there is a specific manner, there is a specific way, a procedure that you will have to go through, and there are specific supplications that you have to recite. you open the Holy Quran in front of your face. You sit towards the Kaaba, towards Mecca, on your prayer mat, and you recite this dua: Allahumma inni asbahtu wa amsaytu 'abdan laka. Until the rest of the supplication, you submit towards Allah Subhanahu wa Taala all of your actions during that year, and then you place the Holy Quran on top of your head, and you mention the names of the 14 infallibles. You start with the name of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. You repeat it 10 times. Bika ya Allahu, bika ya Allahu, bika ya Allah. 10 times, and then you move on to the name of the Holy Prophet. Bi Muhammadin, and then bi Aliyin, bi Fatimata, bil Hasani, bil Husayni. And then until the end of the names of the 14 infallibles. When you reach the name of Imam al Mahdi alayhi salam, you stand and you supplicate 10 times with the name of the Al-Imam alayhi salam bil hujjati salawatullahi alayhi, and then straight afterwards you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what you want, your hajat. And the first and foremost hajat and the needs we want from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to hasten the reappearance of the Imam, the awaited Imam. Our awaited Imam is in ghaiba. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this year, inshallah, the year that our awaited Imam is going to reappear. The fifth act is to pay sadaqah, to pay charity. We always remember the ones who are needy during the year, but in that night we pay sadaqah for the life and the soul of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam, for his protection, for his well-being, for the well-being of the ulama, those who serve the community, and those who are the representatives of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and representatives of the imams, those who guide us towards Islam and guide us towards Ahlul Bayt, and for the well-being of ourselves and the mu'mineen and mu'minat wherever they may be. So sadaqah, brothers and sisters, paying charity is very important. The next act that it is widely encouraged to be practiced during these nights is the visitation of Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi, ziyaratul Imam al-Husayn Laylatul Qadr. And if one can be present next to the grave and burial site of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, that is the merrier. Why? Because we have a narration. We have a narration from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam that says that the one that is able to be present Laylatul Qadr by the grave and by the burial site of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, no doubtedly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them all of their sins. So all of our sins, all of our mistakes will be forgiven that night, for the sole reason that we have visited Imam Hussein alayhi salam. There is a specific ziyarah, a specific dua and supplication allocated to Imam Hussein for that specific night. And the brothers and sisters are encouraged to at least once in their lifetime to be in Karbala on the night of Qadr, the night of power. The next amal, or the next act that it's advisable, is the recitation of dua Jawshan al-Kabir. This is a very beautiful dua, very beautiful supplication, that during the supplication, during the recitation of this dua, you will come to know and understand some of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and some of the attributions allocated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought down upon his mankind. Dua ya uddati is one of the other supplications that is advisable for one to recite. And then a two rak'ah salah, similar to the salat of the morning prayer, salat al-subh. You recite after surat al-hamdu, surat al-tawheed 7 times. So two rak'ah after surat al-hamd, surat al-fatiha, you recite surat al-tawheed 7 times. And then after finishing off, you do tasbihat al-zahra salamullahi alayha. And then after that, you do istighfar 70 times. You say astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh 70 times. Of course, inshallah, we will mention there are specific acts to these nights, the 19th, the 21st, and the 23rd. Inshallah, we will mention them in another episode. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.